Hi there, and welcome to Canny. This video is meant to be a full tour of our software, so if you're looking for a particular feature, you should see a list of timestamps just below this video in the description. Now let's get started. The heart of Canny is going to be our boards. A board is just a collection of ideas we refer to as posts. We have several different options for boards depending on who we want feedback from. Public boards are viewable by anyone, perfect for gathering feedback from our customers and prospects. Private boards allow us to restrict access to only verified, logged-in users. We can also limit our private boards to internal employees or even to specific individuals. Feel free to create multiple boards. We can mix and match for different needs. Once our boards have been created, we can start receiving feedback. It's always good to create the first few posts yourself so that others have an example. Just fill in the title and add some details. Once it's on the board, anyone with access to that board will be able to add their vote on that post. By the way, when a user is creating a post in Canny, they're also searching for any posts that have been created before. They may find that a request they wanted has already been submitted and completed. Canny also helps prevent unnecessary support tickets. Often a user just wants to request a feature and doesn't need any questions answered. One of our larger customers said Canny lightens their support load by as much as 20%. We can also add a voter manually if we receive feedback in a phone call or email. Canny also connects with popular tools like Salesforce, Intercom, and Zendesk, so our team can add votes without exiting their usual workflow. People can also comment on a post. Replying to a comment will automatically send an email to that commenter. If an admin adds a top-level comment, everyone who voted will get an email. This is a great way to reach out to multiple users who have expressed interest in that particular request. If we want to discuss a post with our team, use internal comments. These are only visible to fellow Canny admins and can't be seen by users. Perfect for any sensitive or technical information that doesn't make sense to share publicly. Once posts start coming in, we can easily triage and organize things. We want to be able to quickly and easily find the feedback that's most relevant. First, Canny allows us to create categories for any boards. Categories can be viewed and selected by users when creating a post. But we can reassign a post to a different category if needed. This allows our users to pitch in and reduce our workload when organizing posts. Next up, we can assign tags to a post. Unlike categories, tags are not visible to users, and we can have more than one tag assigned to a given post. Tags are perfect for things like priority levels or grouping by team. We can also assign a post to an individual owner. Just pick the fellow Canny admin we want to assign. Now that we've done some organizing, let's take a look at analyzing our posts. First off, we can set up filters on the left-hand side of the page. We can even save this combination of filters for easy access later. Saved filters are at the top of the post list. Here we can also sort by trending, top voted, newest, oldest, and monthly recurring revenue, or MRR for short. Canny lets us pass in user and company data, including monthly spend. This way we can also see the financial impact of a given post. These attributes we pass in can also be used to create segments. This allows us to filter and see feedback from key user groups without input from the whole user base. For example, I can filter to see feedback from only paying customers. This is perfect for separating the signal from the noise and focusing on the needs of our key users. With Canny, we can use feedback to inform what our team should be working on. Speaking of which, let's take a look at the Roadmap tab. Here we can build and prioritize our team's development roadmap. Each roadmap can have its own set of impact factors, and each factor can be a different type. For example, we can choose a Fibonacci mode of scoring if we're using a more advanced planning model like RICE, or just a simple 1-5 star rating if we prefer to keep things simple. Each impact factor can have a different weight to it as well. These impact factors are then divided by an effort score. We can also choose from a range of options here too. By the way, the full breakdown of our scoring formulas is available in our help docs. Once we're all set on the impact and effort factors, we can select posts from our board to add to the roadmap and score each factor. The goal here is to make development decisions a snap. Just pull up Canny and see which post has the highest score. From here, we can push it to our development integrations like ClickUp, Jira, or GitHub so that as our team makes progress, Canny updates our users automatically. If we don't necessarily want to link a post to a development integration, all we need to do is update the status of a post to close the feedback loop with our users. By default, Canny is set to notify everyone who voted on that post whenever there's a change to the status. We can also add a personalized note to the email before saving. Once the new status is saved, everyone who voted on that post will get an email notification with our logo and color scheme letting them know about the update. This keeps users engaged and shows them our progress as we go. Users can also check out our roadmap page on Canny to see what posts are in the pipeline. As we update the statuses, posts will automatically appear in their corresponding columns. By the way, users will only see posts from boards where they have access. The end user roadmap is optional, but we recommend it. You'd be amazed at how much more patient people are when they can see what we're working on. Once our team releases a feature, we can announce it to the world via the changelog. Canny's changelog is easy to share and easy to navigate. We can also create custom labels for users to filter updates that are most relevant to them. Optionally, we can also embed the changelog right into our product with a simple widget. This way, users can be easily updated without leaving our product. Now that we've got a feel for the basics, there are a few things we recommend as soon as you get started. First, invite your teammates to be Canny admins. Anyone who will need to manage or take action on feedback should be an admin in Canny. If that person is only providing feedback, though, they don't need to be an admin. Next, connect your integrations. Head over to your settings and make sure Canny is communicating with your existing tools. It's way easier for your team to adopt an addition to their existing tools rather than learning something entirely new. Thanks to our integrations, you don't even have to log into Canny for something as simple as adding a vote. Last but not least, put Canny within reach. People won't give you feedback if you don't show them where and how to give it. Thankfully, there are plenty of options available no matter your use case. Sending out a link to your Canny board is a great way to kick things off and invite a burst of feedback. Just remember, it's a short-term way of doing things, so make sure you also have a permanent way for people to find Canny. The most common way to do that is to simply add a link to Canny into your product and install our simple SDK. This way, users are effectively logged in automatically and providing feedback is seamless. Canny's own feedback board is just two clicks away from anywhere in the app. You can also embed a Canny board into one of your pages using a widget if you prefer. This way, users stay on your site and you can further customize the design. Our friends at Taskade have a great example of what that might look like. Full details on the widget view are in our Help Center. It's also a good idea to add a link to Canny on any support page or FAQ page you may have. This is often where users are most keen to give feedback. Connecting integrations also puts Canny within reach. For instance, our Slack integration makes it a breeze for your team to add votes or create posts in mid-conversation. Or you can add our intercom widget so users can easily submit ideas without having to go through your support team. Whether you're using Canny internally between teams or gathering feedback from customers, just make sure they have a quick and easy way to find Canny. Then watch the feedback start rolling in. With that, you're all set to get started. Of course, we're here to help if you need it. We have detailed technical docs for easy installation, as well as guides to everything from mobile widgets to Canny's powerful API. You can also visit our Help Center for simple, step-by-step guides and tutorials like this one. If you have any suggestions, we use Canny too. Feel free to visit our boards and vote on what you'd like to see. When you need a human, we have those too. Just click on the live chat button and one of our experts will help answer any questions. We're looking forward to working with you. Thanks, and make it a great day.